Hello students, so here this is a video for revision of the chapters, okay, that is atomic structure and organic chemistry before your exam. So this is basically a revisional video. So along with the video I have provided one worksheet where you can find the important questions, okay, for your exam. So one by one I will discuss the questions with you and the answers also. So in that worksheet, the first question that you can see, that is, describe the instability of atomic structure as a drawback of Rutherford's model. Okay, so this question, that is actually the drawback of Rutherford's model. So in Rutherford's model we have seen already three main drawbacks. So the first drawback was the instability of the atom, because according to electromagnetic theory, the electrons are charged particles, and as they are continuously moving around the nucleus, so they should continuously lose energy, and at a time after losing all of its energy, it will come closer to the nucleus, and after a certain time it will fall over the nucleus. So in that case there would be no stability of the atomic structure. So this point that you have to define, that you have to explain under this question, okay. Already the answer is given in your notes, so from there you have to write. Just only you have to identify the questions properly. Next question there is given, what is the main difference between electromagnetic theory and Planck's quantum theory? Okay, question number 2, difference between electromagnetic theory and Planck's quantum theory. So what is their basic difference? Only one point you have to write under this question. So the basic difference between them you have to write, okay. So according to electromagnetic theory, the energy is absorbed or it is emitted continuously, okay, from an atom. The energy, whether it is absorbed or whether it is emitted, it takes place in the form of continuous radiation or in the form of continuous wave. But in case of Planck's quantum theory, energy, whether it is absorbed or emitted, it takes place discontinuously. That means not continuous energy radiation takes place here, it takes place discontinuously and in the form of packet, in the form of packets, where one packet energy is called one quanta, and the energy of one packet is expressed by this equation, E is equals to H into nu. Okay, so the basic difference is here the energy emission or absorption that takes place continuously, and here energy emission or absorption takes place discontinuously and in the form of energy packets or quanta. Okay, where the energy of one photon, that is represented by one quanta. Okay, one quanta means what? One quanta means energy of one photon. Photon means the particle which carries the energy. So energy of one photon, that is represented by quanta, that is expressed by this equation, E is equals to H nu. So when you are watching this video, so write this answer in your copy. Okay, so you can write it by this way in a column, or also you can write it just by giving the points and then describe it. So under the first point, right here, energy is absorbed or emitted. Energy is absorbed or emitted continuously for electromagnetic theory. That means energy is emitted or absorbed continuously in case of or for electromagnetic theory. Okay, and next, in this case right here, energy is absorbed or emitted discontinuously in the form of quanta. Full stop. Here quanta represents the energy of one photon. Quanta represents the energy of one photon. Then write comma, E is equals to H into nu. So if E is the value of energy, okay, so therefore this is called one packet. This is called one packet and this is called quanta. Okay, so one packet of particle that represents what amount of energy, that is H into nu. So this is the main difference. That was the second question. Okay, next question number 3. Write any 3 postulates of electromagnetic wave theory of Maxwell. So this question also already it has been discussed in the class, that what are the postulates of Maxwell's electromagnetic wave theory. So you have to see the answers from the PDF notes. Next question number 5. Draw and explain the relationship of intensity and wavelength for black body radiation. So already black body radiation is also discussed in the class, and as well as one graph you have seen there, where the relationship between intensity and the energy, intensity and the wavelength of the particles, that has been discussed. So in this question you have to draw that graph. Okay, that graph you have to show for different temperatures, as well as you have to explain that. Already everything is given in your PDF notes, so check there. Next is number 6. Question number 6. In photoelectric effect, kinetic energy of the ejected electrons increases with increase in frequency. So the next part after black body radiation, we have discussed this phenomenon, that is the photoelectric effect. And in photoelectric effect, we have discussed there the term, that is threshold frequency. Okay, so just you have to show the equation for this, that what is the equation by which we can calculate the energy of the emitted electron. So here you have to show the equation. Wait, the equation, that is H nu, that is kinetic energy of the ejected electron. So here this equation, that is kinetic energy of the, this question is also discussed in the class, though I am just explaining this part. Kinetic energy of the ejected electron is equals to H nu minus H into nu zero. Okay, H nu minus H into nu zero. So what does H nu represent here? H nu is here the energy of the incident photon. Energy of incident photon. And this is actually the binding energy. H nu zero actually represents the binding energy, okay, by which the electrons are bound inside the atom. So this frequency, this is the least value of frequency which is required to eject the electron. So this frequency is also known as threshold frequency. Now this equation can be written as H into न्यू माइनस न्यू जीरो इज इक्वल्स टू काइनेटिक एनर्जी. नाउ रीड द क्वेश्चन. इन दिस क्वेश्चन इट इज रिटन दैट इन फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द इजेक्टेड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इंक्रीजेस विद इंक्रीजिंग इन द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ इंसिडेंट लाइट. ओके विद इंक्रीज इन फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ इंसिडेंट लाइट. सो हियर फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ इंसिडेंट लाइट मीन्स दिस वन नॉट द थ्रेशोल्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी. ओके फ्रीक्वेंसी मीन्स द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ द इंसिडेंट लाइट. सो दैट मीन्स whenever the value of nu increases, obviously the kinetic energy will also increase. Okay, so as well as the frequency of kinetic energy increases, the frequency of incident light increases, kinetic energy will also increase. So first you have to show this equation. Okay, I'm just telling how to write the question, how to write the answer. So first you have to So first you have to write this equation here, that kinetic energy of the ejected electron. First you have to write in case of photoelectric effect, in case of photoelectric effect, kinetic energy of the ejected electron is equals to h nu minus h nu zero, where h nu means energy of incident photon, and incident means that is falling on the metal surface, and what is nu? Nu is the frequency of incident light. Okay, nu is the frequency of incident light. So according to the question, if frequency of incident light, if nu is greater than nu zero, if the incident frequency is greater than the threshold frequency, when the incident frequency is greater than the threshold frequency, then what will happen? Kinetic energy of the ejected electron increases. Okay, kinetic energy of the ejected electron increases, because here nu greater than nu zero means there will be the formation of some extra energy. Okay, when you are subtracting this, the result that you are getting from here, that will be more if the subtracted value will come more, or if the subtracted value will come high. So the more is the energy, the more is the result that you are getting here, that will be converted into kinetic energy. So more is the difference between them, that means more is the value of frequency of incident light. If in the question incident light is not written, that means you have to understand it that it is representing the frequency of incident light. So more is the frequency. Now write this line. After writing this, if nu greater than nu zero, kinetic energy of incident light, kinetic energy of the ejected electron increases. So now in the last line, write there. Therefore, more is the frequency of incident light More is the frequency. This is question number six that I am now discussing. More is the frequency of incident light, comma, more will be the kinetic energy of the ejected electrons. Okay, this question is very important. More will be the kinetic energy of ejected electrons. So in this way, you have to write this answer. So in the question, there is given increase in frequency. The question, again I am repeating the same question. In photoelectric effect, kinetic energy of the ejected electrons increases with increase in frequency. So in frequency means it will be frequency of incident light. Okay. Next question. Question number 7. Define atomic spectrum with example. Okay. That also I have discussed in the class. Next question number 8. Give any one difference between emission spectrum and absorption spectrum. Emission spectrum, absorption spectrum also discussed already. Then a few numericals are given in the question. This numericals already I have discussed during our online classes. Okay. And I have already provided them in the worksheet also. All of you have done these things that you can find here. Next is electronic configuration you have to write. So electronic configurations already you know. But I am just showing you few electronic configurations that are for cations or for anions. Suppose you have to determine the electronic configuration for iron Fe2+. Okay, that you have to determine. So first you have to remember what is the atomic number of iron. The atomic number of iron is 26, right? Now just write down the electronic configuration for this. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2. Up to 4s2, there will be total 20 electrons, right? Up to 4s2, there will be total 20 electrons. Now, how many electrons are remaining here? 6 electrons remaining. So, the 6 electrons will go to the 4p. Wait. 4s, 3s, 3p, 4s. Okay, after 4s, there will be 3d. After 4s, 3d will come. So, that 6 electrons will go to the 3d, right? The extra 6 electrons will move to the 3d orbital. So, now the electronic configuration for iron is this one. Now, when we are calculating for Fe2+, 2+ means what? Deficiency of 2 electrons or lack of 2 electrons. So, that means Fe2+, it is removing 2 electrons, okay, from the valence shell. Now, from where the 2 electrons we will lose, from where the 2 electrons will go out, there are 2 orbitals lastly. One is 4s, another one is 3d. So now the question is, from which orbital we will remove these 2 electrons? So the answer will be from 4s. Okay, from 4s orbital, you have to remove these 2 electrons. Just because 3s, 3p and 3d, these 3 are inner orbitals and 4 is the outer orbital. Okay, the first orbital is for n is equals to 1. Second orbital is n is equals to 2. Third is n is equals to 3, and last one is n is equals to 4. So the last 2 electrons that will be removed from the 4. But whenever you are filling up the electrons, then 4s will come first, because according to Auerbach principle, the lower energy orbitals will be filled first with electrons, after that the higher energy orbitals. But while you are removing the electrons, you have to remove the electrons from the orbitals carrying higher number of n. Okay, so here these 2 electrons will be removed out. So for Fe2+, just you have to write this one. Again I am showing Fe2+. Okay, Fe2+. So here will be 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, and then 3d6. Okay, this is for Fe2+. Same case will happen for aluminium +3 also. Okay, first the electrons will go from the orbitals having larger number of n, and after that from the inner orbitals. So Al3+, try by yourself. And for Cl-, what will be for Cl-? So chlorine normally has 17 electrons, but in case of Cl minus, there will be total 18 electrons. So what will be electronic configuration? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Total 10 electrons done. Then 3s2. 3s2 means 12 electrons. Now 3p5. Okay, this is for chlorine 17. Now as it is accepting one more electron, so it will go to its last valence shell. That means in the p orbital it will go. So for Cl minus it will be 3p6. Okay, so by this way you have to do these things. Next three numericals I have given here. Okay, two numericals are there. This numericals also I have discussed during classes, so you will be familiar to them. Next is question number 6. Derive de Broglie's equation from Planck's quantum theory and Einstein's law of mass energy equivalence. That means, I'm just telling, all of them have been discussed during classes. Just the questions you have to identify and then you have to write the correct answer. Don't confuse in this case. Okay, so derive de Broglie's equation. So de Broglie's equation means what is the de Broglie equation? That also we have discussed. De Broglie's equation means here E is equals to lambda is equals to H by M into C. This is the de Broglie's equation. So this equation you have to derive. You have to show the derivation by using the first equation, that is Planck's quantum theory. According to Planck's quantum theory, E is equals to H nu, and Einstein's law of mass energy equivalence. That means E is equals to M into C square. So by comparing them, you can write it as H nu is equals to M into C square. Then you have to derive this formula from this equation. So nu can be written as C by lambda, then M into C square. After that, cross multiplication, that will be done here. Then you have to derive this one. This equation you have to derive from them. This also has been discussed in the class. So go through the notes properly. Okay. Next is for organic chemistry. So for organic chemistry, all the things that I have given here, that all are from your PDF notes. Okay. So just go through the worksheet and then just go to the PDF notes. From there you can see all the answers there. Okay. So nothing more than this. All the the questions that are given in the worksheets are just from the questions that I have discussed during the classes. Okay, so you will not feel uncomfortable in these questions. So best of luck to all of you for your exam. Okay, so we will meet on the day of exam. Till then, all of you study well, prepare well. Okay, work hard. That can give you success only. Thank you everyone for watching this video. Have a nice day.